Hey Wizards! I'm Ryan.
And I'm Amanda.
And you're watching BGTV.
On today's episode, we are going to take a trip to the past with Gabby and Mr. Anson at Taft Elementary School.
Next, Colin will give an update on Wizards sports games and matches.
Tabitha will be delivering a PSA on the benefits of being outside.
Anna Lee will be covering Poetry Month with Mrs. Tadaro.
Sean Beck will meet with some of our senior class's top 10 students.
Finally, our on-the-street correspondent, Dennis, will be talking to high school students who have unrecognized talents.
If any student is interested in trying out for spring sports, which begin on Monday, April 19th, Family ID will remain open until Wednesday, April 14th. Don't delay. It will close at the end of the school day on April 14th. There will be no extensions for registrations. You must fill out all necessary paperwork in order to try out. Students must have a current physical in order to try out. Please make sure you have checked with your coach as to what time tryouts will begin on April 19th.
Any girl interested in playing varsity or JV softball should attend the informational Google Meet on Monday, April 12th at 6 p.m. Please stop by the pool if you have any questions.
Last but certainly not least, the 2021 to 2022 WHS Science Honor Society is now accepting applications from new candidates. Current juniors and sophomores are eligible to apply.
The application and science teacher recommendation forms can be found on Google Classroom. No late applications will be accepted. Hey Amanda, do you remember anything from your elementary school days?
No, not really. I think Gabby needs to fill us in.
I agree. Let's head on over to Taft Elementary School with Gabby Gellies and Mr. Anson.
Hey Wizard Nation, Gabby Gellies here, and today we're in front of Taft Elementary to interview some of the teachers and get a blast from the past. So when I was in your class, I was in third grade, and now you teach fifth grade. So what are some of the things that you have implemented and you had to let go?
Well, the things I had to let go is being so little. They were always coming up to me wanting a hug and, you know, yeah. Things like that. Fifth graders, they no longer want to do that. They, I tell people I'm no longer a rock star. I'm just a backup singer now. They don't love me like they did in third. The things that I was able to implement, some of my conversations, I could get much deeper with the conversation. And they're very good, where I thought a third grader could understand what I was talking about, not really. But yeah. Fifth grade, I can now, they understand.
So how are you preparing your fifth graders for entering the middle school?
It's a challenge right now, especially in the climate we're in with the virus. These guys are only used to 2 days a week, and now I have to get them back into 5 days a week. And they even told them they're gonna be waking up a lot earlier, and that's gonna be a rude awakening for some, because even at 8:30 in the morning, some of them look tired, and they're gonna be about almost an hour and a half into school there. But my mantra is for them, they just gotta be, I get them ready. I tell them, I'm not trying to scare you, I'm trying to prepare you. So everything I tell them, you gotta make sure you have your work, you gotta be responsible. Yeah. It's up to you if you have a question for the teacher, if you don't understand something, that's my biggest thing. I told them they gotta be very vocal, and they gotta let the teacher know when they're having trouble. You know, it's okay to have trouble, just let the teacher know so they can help you. So that's my biggest thing. I want them to be a little more responsible for their own actions, and mom and dad, you know, it's not gonna be mom and dad next to you anymore, it's gonna be just you, so they have to get that responsibility piece really
exactly.
Keyed in. Yeah,
yeah. Communication, it's a big thing in the middle school and high school going on. Yeah, that's awesome, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Wow, Gabby, thank you so much for bringing back all of those fascinating memories from elementary school. Hey, Amanda, how are Wizards sports doing?
Wizards sports have been crushing it. Let's take a closer look with our sportscaster, Colin Dorothy.
Hey, Wizards, Colin Dorothy here as your new sportscaster. This week has been filled with exciting games. Here is this week's sports recap. On April 3rd, varsity football lost a hard-fought game against Middletown, 28-14. Both Kai Bohanicki and Jack Del Judah scored. They look to get back onto the winning side this week when they play Pine Bush on April 9th. Varsity boys soccer played Middletown on April 7th and won 3-0. Nate Buckus, Will Rich, and Jackson Mitchell all scored a goal. They look to stay on the winning side when they play Valley Central on April 9th, which is also their senior game. Varsity girls soccer played Monroe Woodbury on April 6th and tied 1-1. Maddie Mowbray scored. Later this week, the team plays Middletown on April 8th and will also play Valley Central on April 10th. Varsity volleyball lost a hard-fought game against Valley Central on April 7th, 3-1. They look to get revenge against Valley Central on April 8th and also play Warwick on April 9th, which is also their senior game. Good luck to all the Wizards that play this week, and I will see you guys next week.
Thanks, Colin, so much for the recap of our awesome Wizard sports.
With virtual learning, it's so important to get outside and get some fresh air.
Let's see what Tabitha Scott has to say on her PSA about the benefits of being outside.
As the weather gets nicer, it is important to get outside and get active. Getting outside is very good for your health. Spending time outside lowers your blood pressure and reduces stress. Getting outdoors can be as simple as reading a book outside or a little more strenuous like a hike. Getting outside is a tranquil, easy, and stress-free activity that will do nothing but good for you and your body.
It's great to get outside.
I agree. Hey, Amanda, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I think so.
All right, then let's say it on three. One, two, three.
It's Poetry Month!
Let's head on down with Anna Lee and Mrs. Todaro talking about Poetry Month.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. My name is Annalie Dorzinski, and April is actually Poetry Month. I had the lucky opportunity to speak to Mrs. Todaro herself and learn more about it and why poetry is so important. Let's go see what she has to say.
I'm Mrs. Todaro. I teach English here at the high school, 9th, 11th, and 12th grade Shakespeare course. So April is National Poetry Month, so I try to encourage teachers, staff, and students to submit their poems to me so other people can read them. And then this way we can sort of promote poetry in our building. I especially think it's more important this year than ever, because a lot of people were going through a lot of things with the pandemic, and writing out how you feel can be very therapeutic. In fact, on the radio this morning, I heard a statistic that 42% of Americans started writing poetry this year more than they ever have in previous years because of the pandemic. So for all my English classes, I offer, you know, extra credit. Other English teachers I know do the same thing, even in history class they have. And I really do encourage people to write and submit so other people can enjoy and maybe even find comfort in your writings. Sonnet 18. By William Shakespeare. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often his gold complexion dims. And every fair from fair sometimes declines, by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. By thy internal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death bread thou wanderest in his shade, when internal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long live this, and this gives life to thee.
Perfect. you want to learn more about Poetry Month and submitting your poems to be showcased in the hallways, stop by room 134 and talk to Ms. Todaro. And for a special treat, stay after the credits and we can hear some poems written by our own Washingtonville students. But until then, this is Annalie signing off.
Thanks, Annalie, so much for the insight on this year's Poetry Month.
Now we're going to take a look at some of our senior top 10 with Sean Beck.
Hey Wizards, Sean Beck here. Today we're going to acknowledge all the hard work the seniors have done throughout their high school career with acknowledging the top 10 in our class. Let's go. I'm here with John Casty, the valedictorian of the class of 21. John, what was your biggest motivation to work hard throughout all these years?
I'd say my friends motivated me the most throughout the years to work hard in school. The goal was never exactly to be at the top, and I don't really like to harp on that. I'm more grateful that I became great friends with some really amazing people like Ryan, Mark, and Gianna, who are also in the top 10. As friends, we were always there to help each other.
I'm here with Ryan Lerner, number 6 in our class. Ryan, what advice do you give to the younger kids to be in your position?
I definitely think the most important thing is to have fun and to take advantage of every opportunity given to you and learn for the sake of learning and challenge yourself. And as one of my former teachers, Mr. Rosengarten, used to always say, precrastination is the best way for success.
I'm here with Caitlin Edgar, the number 7 of the class of 2021. Caitlin, was it stressful to maintain that position?
I honestly wasn't very focused on the rank as opposed to how well I can do in every situation.
That's a wrap, and remember, you don't have to be in the top 10. It's a great accomplishment, but try your hardest, do your best, and finish the year strong. This is Sean Beck signing off.
Thank you so much, Sean, and congratulations to all the students in the senior class of 2021 who made the top 10. We are so proud of you.
There are so many unrecognized talents in Washingtonville, and our on-the-street correspondent, Dennis Hayes, will give us the inside scoop.
What's good, Wizards? This is Dennis Hayes here with BGTV, and today we're going to talk about unrecognized talent. So I got a couple of people to interview, the YouTube, rap, etc. We're just going to see what they're all about. All right, let's go.
I'm here with a wannabe celebrity right here. Now, what do you do?
My name is Nelly Tuleti. I rap. I rap, you know, make songs.
So what do I do? What inspired you to rap?
I went to a concert backstage, and it just inspired me just to be back there in the VIP. Experience and everything. You
know? Which concert was that?
John Bellion and Logic.
Oh, okay. Okay. So Logic's are like a real good rapper, right?
Like, yeah, Logic. You. I mean, he's one of the first rappers I started listening to from the beginning. So
he's what they call a lyricist. Yeah, he inspired you?
Yeah, he didn't inspire me to rap, but he inspired me to want to become a performer. That's what he inspired me.
So you listen to his music? Oh, so you can rap? Is what you're telling me.
Oh yeah.
So let me hear some right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me hear some.
All right, we gonna have to pause that real quick. Come back with another.
So right now we got the Nelly Tuleti concert. I'ma let the boy have it.
Yeah, I'm just gifted. Making this music just got me so lifted. The feeling it give me got me so committed. All those lies, baby, had me twist. We're catching our moments I should have predicted. Stay to myself, now they call me wicked. My circle small.
So where can we find your music at? That was hot.
SoundCloud, Nelly Tuleti. It's 2 with the number.
2 with the number.
Yeah, with
so
the number.
Spell it out for me.
N-E-L-L-Y, number 2, L-I-T-T-Y, Nelly Tuleti. I'm gonna be there one day. You already know, $1 million conversation right here.
He's next up. All right, you can cut the clip.
A few moments later. We'll be right back.
I'm here with Real, the next YouTuber, right? You're a YouTuber?
Yeah. Yeah.
So what you want to do?
I want to do public interviews and basketball videos.
Basketball videos?
Yeah.
Oh, so I'm going to ask you a couple questions. You can get a shout out for two. Pig? All
right,
so we're going to play pig real quick. It's kind of like horse, but except you just go to pig. And yeah, let's pull up. Aside from basketball videos and stuff, what else do you want to post on YouTube?
That one there, by the way. On YouTube, I want to post a couple of interviews and IRL bowl videos.
What's IRL?
Just playing basketball in real life.
P. So, what really like inspired you to start making YouTube videos?
I watch YouTubers, Devontae, Frigga, and Odom, and like they just inspired me.
Have you posted on YouTube yet?
No, I haven't posted any videos yet.
So, when are you planning on posting?
I've been posting like somewhere within this month. I've been kind of busy.
So, what's your first video gonna be?
That's I. My first video is gonna be probably a public interview. But maybe if I go to a ballpark with my friends, then maybe that.
What's your goal next year for YouTube?
My goal is probably like maybe 5K because I just started. So, I'm hoping maybe even 5K, 10K.
That's cool. I'm gonna get them out right now. This is about to be game right here.
He not
getting
me up. He not like that.
Oh.
That's
sorry for the abrupt ending, but here's how you can find Nelly Tulidi's SoundCloud and Rail's YouTube channel. He'll be posting soon. See you next time on Dilly Dallying with Dennis.
That's all for this week, Wizards.
Don't forget to check out our weekly newsletter and podcast to find students engaged in on very interesting topics.
Thanks for watching
BGTV.
Democracy is. Democracy can be many things. One thing is for sure, though, it does not have any kings. Some think it's good in that there's no falsehood. Some think poorly of it and want more productive summits. It is a system that doesn't want to undermine. Instead, it strives for a solution, compromise. Democracy is meant for solving problems. It is where justice blossoms. We are given individual freedom, and the worth of the person is the reason. Democracy looks like it may mistreat, but both majority and minority voices make this system complete. In democracy, there's an important principle. That is the worth of the individual, which is what makes this system so pivotal. Though, in other forms of government, this might be minimal. We the people are treated equal, and if we are not, there is upheaval. The rights of Americans are irremovable, and to do so would be unsuitable. Most importantly, if we put it shortly, no matter what leaning, this is democracy's true meaning.